This is so lovely. I really, really, this is an artist you can almost touch. So, and the other thing I want to show you is something which I received today, totally unexpected. I told you that I'm actually in an application training and in this building. Oh, no, just before I forget, there's another Wendy Andrew card. I totally forget it. This one, I said to you, she's fond of hairs, and here's one of her hair cards. Loving the Yule Dawn, yeah. I think I'm getting more and more fond of hairs and Yule in combination. I think this will be strange for others who are not familiar with this, but maybe one day you will find a hair on my Yule altar or for Yule decoration or something like that. So let's see what will come out of it. So back to my surprise today. So I was at my application training, and there in the entrance area was a little box where someone put cards in it. And yeah, simply the simply sentence on the box said, for free. And I looked through, and suddenly there was a topic. The cards were all divided into topics like flowers, Christmas cards, funny stuff, and the category or the topic fantasy. And it totally blew my mind. Of course, it was more pagan than fantasy. Some of the artists, one artist I know, of course, it's a German artist. He's called Hans Werner Sahm, and this is one of his pictures, and it was totally fitting for air, I thought. It's always, he does really wonderful, wonderful pictures, and I have some cards of him, actually. This was lovely, and here is something which is also very lovely. Look at her. And I don't know how it's called. I'll try to find it out. The greeting, it is called. So there's one from the same artist as this one, The Dream. Try to find out what artist this is. Okay, looks like she's from the Netherlands. Zulamiet Wulfing. Never heard of her. Yeah, printed in the Netherlands. So, some other cards. And here are cards which actually are from Cornwall, which was totally amazing. And when I saw the motif and the topic, it blew my mind. Look at this. It's a card about air. If you don't believe me, look at this. Ruling planets from Linda and Roger Garland, air. And the gods related to it. Secrets of Astrology. Okay, so I have to look, and it was, I thought, oh my gosh, this is so fitting. Air, and another one for air, actually another one, this here. This is really, really, really wonderful. And the planets are, oh no, these are the not the planets, but the zodiac signs. And here's some card for water. Look at that. With Venus on it. This is totally not fantasy. This is so pagan. This is really, really lovely. And there were some other cards This here is actually called Silverberry Down. Some crazy or interesting description on it. Here, look upon the images, for they are the 12 canons of the secret. May you find in them the answer to guide us at the new age dawning. Robert John, okay, Wolfenden, okay. Actually, the price on it. Which, okay, King Arthur Bookshop in Tintagel, okay. So, here's another one. Here is Merlin. Look at this. This is so not fantasy. Not okay, if you want to see it as fantasy, you can see it as fantasy, but I think it's totally pagan. Here's another one. This is for Libra. I think this is one for you, Annie. The Labyrinth. Let's see what is. Oh, look at that. It looks like this Irish, what you find on Irish rings. I'm sure I don't speak it correctly. Cladach? Cladach? I don't really know how to spell it. Or how to pronounce it correctly. Let's see, is there something else what you can see? Okay. In the labyrinth I am. This is really, really, really lovely. And here is another one from Roger Garland, and they're called crystal cards, and I only have one card, or I got one card of it, and it's about the amethyst. Look at that. Isn't this, this is really, wow. Cool. This is really cool. And I don't want to have a video about or over 50 minutes, so I make it quick now. Here's another one. This is really... God is like, I have to look what there is standing. I don't think... Maybe you can pause and read it. I try to hold it so the camera can focus. I see it for the first time. I didn't have the time to read it. So, it's from... Oh, there's a lot of writing on it. I try to make it slow so you can read it. Maybe with a pause, I don't know. I try to make it... Okay. And here is another one. This is also very cool. Look at that. This is not a card, actually, like a, not more like a print. It's Earth by Keith English. And this is also lovely. Look at that. Moon meditation. Oh, this is really lovely. So, this was it. Okay, no, not actually complete. Here's something else. This is also lovely. I think I will have to cut the video now into two parts so you can have... This is also lovely. Look at this little girl with an umbrella. And I don't know, is there something on her head? This here? To me it looks almost like a hair, a bunny or something like that. I don't know. It's from a Japanese artist, I see. Ah. Chihiro. Chihiro Iwasaki. Oh, quite early born. 1918. Whoa. Okay. This is really lovely. So. Again, this one. So, you can... you can certainly be sure how amazed I was when I found these incredible cards. Because this was not the place where I expected something like that, to be sure. I really didn't expect this. But this was a totally gift of the goddess, I think. And especially fitting because of the air cards in it. So, so lovely. So, I hope you enjoyed it. I wish you a wonderful Yule time. Maybe with flying reindeers or dreaming on flying reindeers. We will see and hear us during the next days, and I'm really glad when the next 2 days will be over, so I'm back again with my full concentration on our group. And I really miss you all, and I'm happy when I can focus again on all of you. Although I have plenty to do also next week, because there is a handmade market at Egon's Villa for Transition Town on the 20th of December, and I still have to make lots of tasty goodies and some other stuff.